Hi friends, have a warm welcome to you on your own channel Vikas English Academy, which is a large digital platform to provide you everything in English. Every topic of English is explained here. So before going ahead in the video, please subscribe the channel, like the video and share the video as more as you can, so that everyone can get the information of this topic. Today we will talk about the very important topic of grammar, that is pronoun. This is a parts of speech. This is a kind of parts of speech. And today we will know the details of pronoun. So subscribe the channel, click the bell icon, like the video and share it as more as you can. Let's start the video. Pronoun, the word which is used at the place of noun, is known as pronoun. As I have explained before, the definition of pronoun, that the words which are used instead the place of a noun in the sentence are known as pronoun. Here are some examples of pronoun: he, she, it, they, you, etc. There are many kinds of pronoun. Here, 9 kinds are discussed. And if you feel any problem, if you are getting a problem in understanding some fact in the video, you are free to comment me. You are free to ask the topic on my given phone number, my email ID, my Facebook link in the description of the video. The kinds which are discussed in the video are personal pronoun, demonstrative pronoun, interrogative pronoun, indefinite pronoun, possessive pronoun, reciprocal pronoun, relative pronoun, reflexive pronoun, intensive pronoun. And after this, we will note the definition of every kinds of pronoun, and we will also know the example of each type which will be discussed. The first kind is personal pronoun. The pronoun which replaces the proper noun is called personal pronoun. He, she, it, you, I, we, they, etc. I would like to clear you some more, that this pronoun replaces the name of person, so here it is considered as proper noun. This pronoun helps us to replace the name of person, place, thing or animal from the sentences. So this pronoun is known as personal pronoun, and the example are he, she, it, you, I, we, they, it, she. Now come to second kinds, that is demonstrative pronoun. The pronoun which is used to demonstrate, it means indicate something, is known as demonstrative pronoun. Its example are this, that, these and those. This kinds of pronoun help us to indicate something. It means the pronoun which we are talking now, that is demonstrative pronoun, help us to indicate something. So it is known as demonstrative pronoun because it helps us to demonstrate. And this example are this, that, these and those. Next is interrogative pronoun. The pronoun which is used to ask question is known as interrogative pronoun. As like, we used to ask, who are you? Then, who is your interrogative word? And here, who is a pronoun? So that, who is interrogative pronoun? So, from this pronoun, we come to know that the pronoun which is used to ask question is known as interrogative pronoun. All the pronouns which are used to ask question will be known as interrogative pronoun. Okay. Now come to next pronoun, that is indefinite pronoun. What is this? This is indefinite pronoun. The pronoun which point out non-specific thing. Mind it. Pronoun which point out what is non-specific thing are known as indefinite pronoun, as all, some, any, several. It means indefinite means which is not definite, and this pronoun also point out what non-specific thing. So its example are all, some, any, several. Come to next pronoun, that is possessive pronoun. What possessive? The pronoun which are used to show possession is called possessive pronoun. Example, mine, yours, his, hers, our, tradition. Here some highlighted sentences are given in yellow color. This is not of this pronoun, not for this pronoun. These pronouns are sometimes called absolute possessive pronoun to differentiate them from possessive determiners. Some determiners are given in the bracket, that are my, your, his, her, it, our, and their, which are also classified as types of possessive pronoun. So you have to remember this note, because this will help you sometimes to make difference between possessive pronoun and absolute possessive pronoun. So learn this, and if you have problem in this, comment me in the comment section so that I can clear you. Next is reciprocal pronoun. The pronoun which are used for action or feeling that are reciprocated are known as reciprocal pronoun. Example, each, other, and one another. It means what? Each pronoun used for action or feelings. When you feel something, that is feeling, and action means word. Then what do we come to know? We come to know that the pronoun which are used for action or feeling that are reciprocated, known as reciprocal pronoun. Each other and one another are its example. Next is relative pronoun. The pronoun which is used to show relation or relative clause is known as relative pronoun. Who, which, whom, whose are its example. Have you learned relative pronoun? What do you mean about relative pronoun? What do we know about relative pronoun? It's clear through its name. Relative come from relation. So this pronoun is used to show relation or to show relative clause. So, and some example of this pronoun are also given: who, which, whom, whose, etc. Now come to next, that is reflexive pronoun. This is also very important pronoun. you have seen many words which end with self or selves in English sentences, and I know that if you are learning English, if you have any relation from English, you must got these words that end with self or selves. So the pronoun which ends with self or selves and refers to another noun or pronoun in the sentence is known as reflexive pronoun. And here one thing more, that to whom this pronoun will refer in the sentence. So you have to always mind it that this pronoun usually refers to the subject of the sentence. Example, myself, yourself, herself, himself, itself, ourselves, yourself, and themselves are the example of reflexive pronoun. Now come to intensive pronoun. What is intensive pronoun? Then here the definition is given: the pronoun which refers back to another noun or pronoun in the sentence to emphasize it is known as intensive pronoun. Some important thing is given in the bracket also. What is that? That is to emphasize that it is the thing carrying out the action. So, do you know what do intensive pronoun emphasize? Intensive pronoun emphasize that it is the thing carrying out the action. It means intensive pronoun emphasize the word which carry out action or which shows work. As here is one example given for you: John bakes all the bread himself. Who bakes the how did John bakes all the bread? In this example, the intensive pronoun is himself, because it refers back to the noun John. It means himself refers back to John. So himself here is intensive pronoun. Now here a chart is given for you, and this is very important chart, because English Academy has brought this chart only for you. Here are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 columns. First, in the first column, you will see that first person, second person, third person male, next third person female, third thing, first person plural, second person plural, third person, and think plural. First subject pronoun, second object pronoun, possessive adjective, possessive pronoun, reflexive pronoun. All the types of words are given here. The different form of pronoun are given, as I in the subject, that will be me in the object, and that will be my in possessive adjective, and that will be mine in possessive pronoun, and that will be myself in reflexive pronoun. Similarly, you will be you in objective case, yourself. Similarly, he, him, his, himself, she, her, hers, herself. Third thing, it's not used means it is not used in possessive pronoun. Next, reflexive pronoun is itself: we, us, our, ours, ourselves, you, yours, yourselves, they, them, their, theirs, themselves. Thank you. Have you enjoyed the video? You must share me in the comment section. Thanks for watching the video. You can follow me on the following ID if you need the PDF of topics of grammar. Contact me through the given ID and also what do you should do. Don't forget to subscribe the channel, like the video and click the bell icon so that you will get every updates of the channel that will help you to learn many things in the English. Thank you. Have a